Hello everyone and welcome to this Saturday morning stream. It is the morning. It's 10:57 a.m. What the hell am I doing up at this time? No idea. No idea at all. But I fancied some Loeb. So Loeb is what I am doing. It's happening. And I'm just gonna spin through some of this shite here, and get some medals. I'm gonna get some medals. Don't know what to start with. Perfect trajectory. No, we're gonna do Sweden, and we're gonna be the Impreza to start with. That'll do. Right. Let's do this. So welcome to the stream. I've played a lot of Sebastian Loeb. I haven't played this in a couple of days now. But I have played a hell of a lot of it. My plan is to play this until something that's on my radar comes out, like another game. I'm not sure what yet. Hitman, PVZ, GW2, maybe the map pack for COD. Not entirely sure yet. Right, let's get comfortable. Let's assume the racing position.
Three, two, one. Go.
Now we're just going to try and get a gold. Now it's my first race in a couple days, so I'm going to have to get used to the handling again. It's very twitchy. I've been playing a lot of games since I last played this, including the new Naruto Shippuden Ultimate Ninja Storm. I'm going to rewind that. Ultimate Ninja Storm 4. Playing that a lot yesterday, and having never played Naruto before, I've got to say, very bloody enjoyable. Mad as a box of frogs, but very enjoyable nonetheless. Now, there's something I've been thinking about, because I am really enjoying this game. Been thinking about the addition of a Thrustmaster steering wheel. Would that benefit me? Probably. I don't know. I couldn't say. Welcome to the stream, mate. I will catch up on what you're saying in just a second. Sorry, I've just seen your message pop up, but with racing games, it's really bloody hard to stream them at the same time as trying to make the game look good by being as accurate and as quick as possible. But I will get round to your message shortly. Just bear with. Hello, Chunky. Right. Here we go. Pressure now. Pressure now. There's actual humans watching. Oh, look, and I'm down on my sector. Okay. So, you've said... Oh, there's a straight. Thought about getting this, but there's too much DLC. Oh, fucking hell. Look, let's rewind. Thought about getting this, but there is too much DLC for it. There's only, like, there's a season pass, and I think there's 4 cars you can buy, and you don't have to buy the cars at all. There's, with the base game itself, there is twice as much content in the base game as any other rally game that's been released. Alright, twice as much content. Chunky says he's gone from 40 subs to 185 in under a night. Well done, mate. That's a very unprecedented amount. I don't think we've even climbed that much in a night. We get 400-500 a month. So you want to look into that, mate. Because that seems very odd. Right. Motherfucker. Motherfucker. Right. Who the fuck is calling me? Sorry, my phone. My phone went mental. Right, be liberal on the brakes. Fucking hell. It's going to take me a couple of goes to get back into the swing of things. I should get used to this Subaru on the ice about halfway through this this track, and then I'll be ready to roll second time round, I think.
Caution, right three, don't cut 140.
Right three, don't cut 140. What the fuck is going on with my phone? Sorry. My phone keeps on lighting up next to me. PPI calls. You know the score. Hello, do you have any PPI? I don't know. Leave me alone. In fact, I should check that out. I think when I took out my mortgage, I actually got payment protection insurance on it. I'm not entirely sure. The mother-in-law believes I do. And it's something I seriously do need to look into. But I'm not going to take the advice of a speculative spam caller. I shall do my own research. Come on, Jamie, you can pull this back. 3 seconds isn't a big gap in this. Wow, it is when you do that. Right, I'm still buzzing because the other day, on release day, it looks as though I... Right, let's do this. Let's just restart. I may have played Sebastian Loeb himself at this game and beaten him by 33 seconds. Not entirely sure. Right,
two,
come on.
One, go. Left six over
crest. Now, DLC for, as you're saying, there's too much DLC. DLC for this kind of game is only good or becomes expensive when they release tracks, new tracks, or new game options. But at the moment, apart from the season pass, I don't know what is involved in the season pass. I've got an email to tell me, but I haven't read it yet. The offer of more cars doesn't entice me because there are 70 cars in this from the off. 70. All right. If you're telling me you feel the need to go and buy an extra four cars at, I don't know how much they are, they're about £6 each, there's literally no need. There's really no need to go and do that straight away. You're not going to be, you're not going to have got through all the content of the base game for a very long time. I've pumped over 30 hours into this, and I haven't even made a bloody dent in the game. Like, I played this all last weekend, solidly, for like 20 hours. My wife was very pleased with that. Yep. but, yeah, there you go. Chunky says he's just nipping out to the shop. Please get me some breakfast. I am starving. There we go. I'm a second down on this sector. See, I'm getting used to the... I'm getting used to the snow and the handling of this here Subaru. 70 cars is impressive, says Bangkokian 1967. It really is. It's if after this stream, if you want to know what else is in this game, dudes, if you check down our timeline on YouTube, I did a what I like to call a quick overview of Sebastian Loeb Rally Evo. Now, my quick overview literally spun through some of the options. I was quite concise in my overview, but the quick overview took me 35 minutes just to talk through the options, the different race modes, some of the different circuits, to talk about the customization options, the handling, the different on-screen heads-up display settings, things like that. That's a 35-minute video, and literally after pumping 30 hours or so into this, I'm still finding new options. For example, I was streaming on Thursday night, streaming this game to a load of people, and I came across a new mode entirely, which was the versus head-to-head race, whereby it pits classic cars so-called rival cars against each other on the same circuit. So, for example, this car I am now, the Subaru Impreza, against the Mitsubishi Lancer Evolution, which I thought was an amazing little touch. Really, really impressive little mode. There's just loads of shit I keep on finding in this game that just blows this game out of the water. Yes, it might not have the same level of realism as another recently released rally game, but it is bloody fun and will keep you entertained for a very long time if you like racing games, and particularly if you're into your rally. I am not a rally fan per se. I am a Formula One fan. I couldn't tell you the first thing about rally apart from I could mention Sebastian Loeb's name and I could mention Colin McRae's name, and that is it. I know nothing about rally, yet I am still enjoying this thoroughly. It has a very steep learn— oh fuck me, look, I'm down on this sector. Has a very steep learning curve though, but you can take it as slowly as you want. You won't get impeded or penalties or anything like that. Yeah, thoroughly enjoyable. There you go, there's my sales pitch. Go and buy it now. Go and buy a physical copy. PlayStation 4 graphics are probably what I'd compare to the lower end scale of graphics settings on a PC version of this. But nonetheless, it still looks pretty nice on the PlayStation. But it looks a hell of a lot nicer on the PC. I can testify to that because I had deleted it now. Had the demo on the PC. There are 6 camera options in total, including third person or exterior. There is a further away camera from exterior. There is this view here, which I like to call the bonnet cam. There is the bumper cam, whereby you can see none of the car, you just get the full track in screen. There is the cockpit cam as well, and there is a dashboard cam. So there's a camera for everyone. Right, last sector, we've got to boot this, guys. Right, that's not booting it, Jamie.
Right
660. Here we go. This is where I catch up my time.
Right 5 Titans and left 650.
Right 5 Titans. Oh, your mum. I'm going to rewind that. Right here. You don't have to rewind. You can turn the rewind features off. I find it handy because I'm talking to you. I can't hear the pace notes. Yes, I could look at the pace notes, but I'm not doing so because I'm an idiot. Keep on the track, you silly boy.
Right 5 minus.
Right 5 minus. Minus meaning just slow it down. It is a right 5, so it is a nice big open turn, but we still need to slow it down. There we go, come on. Bloody hell, that's a long straight. That might be the longest straight in the game. Come on, tell me I just caught up there in that last sector and I got the gold. That would be nice. Yes, I did. I got the gold. Happy times. Just bought it on Steam. Good man. Good man. Just from seeing that. Me doing shitty racing. I hope you've got a powerful PC that can really, really pump the graphics settings. I'm not sure how big it is on... hang on. I'm not sure the size of the game. On here, on the PlayStation version, which is, as I said, graphically inferior to the PC version, but the install is 30 gigabytes on PlayStation 4, so it'll be probably more on the PC. So you should be waiting maybe half an hour or so, depending on your internet connection, for that. Gold, says Ferdinand YouTube. Gold. Your favourite Spandau Ballet tune, I am assuming. I do apologise if that joke is beyond you, but yeah, there you go. 28 gig download, says Bangkokian. Okay, cool. So, I'm assuming you're a Mr. Bangkok. What is your favourite rally game? I'm assuming you're a rally game fan. What would you say is the best rally game? And also, what would you say is an enjoyable racing game, or your favourite racing games? What racing games do you like? Northerner, how long are you on for today? Mate, the wife is away. All I need to do is get some food, and I'll probably get a takeaway because I'm a lazy git. So, all day, all night, whatever. Was only 15 quid on my Steam store. Bloody hell. £15 for this. Your Steam store doesn't sound legitimate. how you doing, Tom? Are you good? So, Thrustmaster, the steering wheel company, have got an official affiliation with Sebastian Loeb. Official. I might tap them up about this. I might well do that. I'm just about to go and get some food and check the charity shops. Oh, you bitch. Alright, man. Keep me in mind. Keep me in mind, rude boy. Right, so look. These are the career mode races, Bangkok. I love the old V Rally games, PS1. Good man. Good man. I think I've got V Rally on the PlayStation 1. I don't know. Massive games collection. My PS1 collection... I need to look through because I cannot remember what I've got in there. V Rally 2 on the Dreamcast was the business. Welcome, Kev. It's in the Thailand store. Ah, cool. So you're actually from Thailand. It's a place I've yet to visit. So this is the career mode here. Debut. And you got three classes in there. I've gold medaled all of these. So I've done them. Don't need to do that. Junior, and you've got four classes in here, and I've barely touched the sides on this one. You've got your master, and there are six different classes in here, and I've really not touched this mode. And we've got our vintage over here, four different classes to go through. New era, three. Extreme, three. Haven't done any of those. You've got your iconics, and 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 different stages there, and six different modes in this open. And in the open category, this is where you've got your versus. So as you can see there, the Mitsubishi Evo versus the Subaru Impreza. Very nice mode indeed. One of my favorite modes so far. And then the final of this career mode here is your Loeb events, and these only unlock one at a time depending on where you place in the world. So you've got to do the other bits of the career to up your ranking, your world ranking. So at the moment I'm about 227th in the world rankings. Need to get to 220th to unlock the Los Angeles Rallycross race, and so on and so on until you become the world champion. Right, so what else? Loeb experience, this is great. This is absolutely great. You're effectively, this is like documentaries about Sebastian Loeb, where he talks about, for example here, his early days from 98 to 99. And then you partake in races to recreate those events in his cars, on those circuits, under those conditions, which is a really nice feature. Amazing, absolutely amazing. As you can see, I've done these. It says events completed 2 of 2, 3 of 3, 3 of 3, and I've started world champion 2004 to 2006. I've done 1 of 4 events. Then there's this in history mode, it's got 4 events, all-time greatest, and there's 7 events there, and then Pike's Peak, 4 events. So there's tons and tons and tons of content. Then there's just quick mode, whereby you would pick either rally, rally cross, Pikes Peak, or time trial. And then within there, you'd pick single stage, single rally, rally championship, and then you go and pick your stages and whatnot. So there really is a hell of a lot of content. So let's carry on. And let's do some of this. Right, Gateway. Right, these are very hard. So Suzuki Swift S1600 event car. Now, this is called an event car because I won it from winning a race. And this Renault Clio R3 was actually the very first car that I purchased in this game. I'm going to change my livery to this. Right. So you shall see this momentarily. So I just need to win this race, and I get 3,000 points, and that will up my position in the global leaderboard for this game. All right. Very excited. Very excited indeed. So, everyone, all six of you, tell me what the last video game you played was. I'd love to know. What was the very last thing you played? Right, I really hate this mode. So, as you can see, I've changed the livery, I still don't know how to pronounce it, to green and white. Why? Because that is the official colours of the game's shed. And you can see my personalised number plate. And on the side, it's got my initials. There you go, JD, with the Union flag.
3, 2, 1, go.
So if we have a look. Okay, I don't know what I'm doing here. Gateway, right, I've got to go through gates. Let's pay attention. Oh, fuck, I hate this mode. Bastard. Fuck. So I'm going to have to do this a few times. You have to go through the correct gate, you see. It's really fucking tough, this mode. The gate markers don't pop up quick enough, in my opinion. And it doesn't help when you smack the fucking shit out of the wall. Right, rewind. Been trying out Division Beta. Kind of reminded me of Defiance. Yeah, do you know what's annoying, right? I've got a beta code on the PC for the Division. Registered. All of that good stuff. Put my key in. Still waiting. Haven't had my email. Very fucked off. So that game can go and fuck itself. I think they've probably just been inundated, gave out too many keys, and their servers can't handle the automated email that lets you download the game. Crap, right, I've got to do it again. Loving the Witness. Yes, I've been looking at that. I do need to get hold of that, I think. Right, I've got a silver medal there. I can do this again. Kev, haven't played enough to decide if I like or hate it. Oh dear, that was kind of like me with Rainbow Six. I got on the alpha, I got on the beta, and do you know what? I don't know if I liked it, and I certainly haven't bought it. Right, let's do this again. We can do this. We can win.
3, 2, 1, go.
Here we go. Right, so through the gates. Just got to hit the green ones, not the red ones. I'm going to keep left here. What the actual fuck? Why, Delilah? That's not a racing line. It doesn't put you on the racing line when it does these gates, which is thoroughly fucking annoying. Because you're trying to guess where the next gate... Why didn't my car turn there? I'm going to restart. Yes, Kev says it's a bit annoying, yeah. Good chance to try the game for free. Let's be honest. Much won't change between now and launch. Exactly. When these guys say beta, it really fucks me off when it's actually not a beta.
Three,
it's a demo.
Two, one, go.
Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. I'm going to nail this. I have to nail this. I used to play a lot of Defiance. I don't know what Defiance... I don't think I've ever played Defiance. Look, look, look. The gate changed. It's alright. I nailed it. Almost. I definitely, definitely hit that wall. So guys, let me know in the comment section below if there's something you want to see in this game that I haven't shown you, or talk about or whatnot. I will do so. Danny's on. You good, Dan? Through we go, through the posts. There we go. Bosch, 10 of 10. Accelerate through to the finish. It was an MMO launched by Triton at the same time as the TV show. Oh, right. Okay. Okay. I've heard of the TV show. I don't play MMOs, so gold. There you go. Done it. And look how fucking nice my car is. So battered. Sebastian Gamer, welcome. I am playing a game of your name, but differently spelt. How are you doing? And how are you, Mr. Danny Dog? DD? I'm following you, Ian. Who's Ian? And why are you following them? Morning all. Morning, Mark. Good cheers, Jay. Loving these streams. Missed the last live one. Caught it. If you watched the last live one, I believe I actually raced Sebastian Loeb in the multiplayer mode. Very, very fucking random, but very enjoyable. Right, so next up. Oh, look, I've got a silver. Perfect trajectory. This is a bastard as well. Perfect trajectory. No. Let's do a sector battle instead. Right. Bud Ape. Yeah, man. Ah, me. Okay. Bangkok is called Ian. I saw that. The last race was great, says Danny. Wasn't it a cracker? I really thought I balls that race, and I managed to pull it back and beat Seb. I called him out on Twitter. He ignored me. Bastard. Yes. Smoke weed. It's not weed. It's just a e-cigarette. Mm. So you see this load time. This is the worst thing about the game. The load time on any track where there are multiple vehicles is horrendous. All right, 1 minute 45 on average for a track with more than one car. Is that acceptable in 2016? I'm not entirely sure. Come on, you bastards. The ghost cars need to be slightly more ghostly. Yes, they certainly do, because they block the fucking circuit. You can't see what you're doing. Hmm. That, for anyone who is unaware, is in multiplayer online racing. The ghost cars, so the other competitors, the ghosts aren't very see-through. And it's really off-putting. I haven't forgotten about the postage, boys. It's coming. Just bear with me. Not a problem, Dan. Not a problem, mate. We've got more than enough to keep us busy. I promise you that.
One, go.
Right, here we go. So I'm going to go to exterior cam just so you can see what's going on. Fuck off. And you can be rough in this mode. Like that, you see? Prick. Don't touch me, you prick. There we go, right. Right, that's enough exterior camera, I think. I don't like any camera apart from this. Do I have a Joker lap on this? Yes, I have to do a Joker lap. A Joker lap is a shortcut. It's not a shortcut, it's a long cut. And you have to do one in your three laps. One of your three laps has to take the long route. So I don't actually know where the entrance to the Joker lap is, so I might fail this. I think there's a Joker lap in this. So I'm zero. Well, I'm a fraction of a second down on the rest of the pack. Fucking hell, I thought that was the Joker lap entrance. Oh, I've been nudged. What happened? Oh, it's not. It's not a Joker lap thing at all. Event completed. I came in first place. That's all you needed to do. Just needed to get fastest sector on each sector. Simple as that. Right, so let's have a little look what you're saying. What's track variety like in terms of countries, etc.? Okay, good question, Kev. I will go through that in a second. You tell everyone about our rubbish list last night. No, I didn't. Oh, mate. Me and Mark had a gaming session for our channel last night where we were going to record lots of videos. And we did record lots of videos. We recorded 5 epic videos. I can only play racing games from cockpit or bumper cam, says Bangkok. Allow Seb, play Naruto. You took Naruto home, Mark. Longer to load than the game mode. Damn. Yep, exactly. What's the name of his Waze card game? I don't know what that means. Can anyone help out? Sebastian. Right, so what courses are available? Right, let's go and show you. So we recorded 5 videos last night. PlayStation 4 and Wii U, and we played PlayStation 4 Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm 4, which isn't out until next week. We played Mario Kart 8, we played Fast Neo Racing, we played a whole load of shit, right? It got to 1 a.m, decided to call it a night, just check back some of our footage, and everything had recorded nicely, apart from the sound on the camera. So we had silence for 5 videos. So crap, essentially crap. So let's go and look at the tracks, the variety of tracks. Rally, let's just pick rally, single stage. We have Wales. Within Wales there are 8 stages. We have Alsace. Oh, I don't know where that is. I think it's in France. We have 8 stages. We have Australia. We have 8 stages. Finland. Guess how many? There's 8. We've got San Remo. Is this San Remo? San Romo? Oh, I can't remember. In Italy, we've got 8 stages. Mexico, 8 stages. Sweden, 8 stages. Monte Carlo, 8 stages. If we back out of this, single rally? No. I think that is exactly the same. Yes, it is. Rally, back out of this. Rally cross, that's what I needed. In rally cross, we have 5 different modes. And within here, Oh, bollocks! I pressed the wrong fucking button. So I was going to show you all the circuits there. Lots of DNFs. Yes, DNF indicates I haven't taken part in the race itself. I'm just concentrating on career at the moment, not quick races. So it registers as a DNF because I haven't set a time. Hello, Gary. Very good, mate. Very good. Loving the Irish green on the motor, Jay. That's not an Irish green. That's a TGS green. There's a subtle difference. Irish green is darker, less fluorescent. TGS green is slightly fluorescent. I can't believe I've just done this. And look, it's going to take a minute 45 because it's multiple cars upon circuit. Let me read you this email. I got an email update from the publishing company, P-Cube, the other day, yesterday, about patches and all that good shit about this game. Hang on. Looks good. I'm tempted. Loving Dirt Rally, but always room for another rally like this one. Yes, I can't play Dirt Rally. It's too fucking hard for me. I haven't pumped enough time into it, to be fair. All rally games are fucking hard, but this... this Dirt Rally, not this game. Dirt Rally is bloody impossible. So, where is my update? Where's the update on this? I can't remember who it's from. Right, exit. Maybe this one. More than 300 kilometers of track, the exclusive Pikes Peak International Hill Climb, 8 different style rallies, Monaco, Sweden, Mexico, Australia, Italy, Finland, France and Wales, 64 special stages, 5 rally cross circuits, Lohac, Los Angeles, Franciacorta, Trois-Rivières, and San Luis. 16 car manufacturers, including Citroen, Peugeot, Ford, Volkswagen, Audi, Subaru, Suzuki, Abarth, etc. It says on this press release, it says 58 cars from the 1960s upwards. There's actually 70 cars if you include the skinned cars. Several game modes, quick race, career, Sebastian Loeb experience, online multiplayer, customization for your car, several weather and light conditions, such as nighttime racing, dawn, dusk, midday, there's snow, rain, mud, everything. Realistic physics and sounds, helped developed with Sebastian Loeb. Amazing compatibility with main driving peripherals available on shelves, steering wheels, change and pedals. Don't know what that means. From day one, it will be available with the first patch for Sebastian Loeb. This includes, the change log includes, improved weight transfer for all vehicles, improved suspension movement for all vehicles, improved the behavior of the dampers for all vehicles, improved gear ratio, improved mapping of engine for Fiat Abarth Grand Punto S2000, improved the mapping of the engine for the Peugeot 205 Pikes Peak, improved mapping for engines, rare, all the way through, improved AI performance, etc. And that patch was 6.5 gigs. You guys get hold of the Division Beta. Yes, we did. We entered the code yesterday morning, yesterday evening, and still haven't had the fucking game. So, not happy. Right, Rallycross. As I was saying, Rallycross race. Let's not press the button this time. There we go. So, here they are. So, that's the Trois-Rivières. Los Angeles, Lohac, San Luis, and this one that I'm not even going to pretend to pronounce. Back out of there. Pikes Peak. Within Pikes Peak, there are 4 different versions. My personal record of 15 minutes 18 seconds was because I completed half the race on three wheels. Yes. Damn, lots of people on Twitter are having the same problem. Oh, right, okay, so that's the division. It's just a pain in the arse, is it? See, DNFs, I haven't done these races. Let's put a time down now for this. Let's pick our car. So this is my garage. These are all the cars I own. Let's do Pikes Peak in a Pikes Peak car. Suzuki SX4 Pikes Peak. Chunky's got an egg butty with brown sorbet, shredded chili, special fried rice, and spring rolls. Mmm. Brown sauce in a cup of tea is fucking deadly. Brown sauce in a cup of tea. Danny, what's wrong with you, bruv? Right, I've never done this race before, so let's try and do it with all four wheels intact. Completed on three wheels, and it wasn't a Morris Minor. Yes, exactly.
Three, 2, 1, go.
Let's do this. I don't know how this car handles. I haven't actually used it yet. Fucking hell, it's twitchy as fuck. There will be swearing throughout this this video, in case you were under any disillusion. I do swear during my games. I am afraid. Bloody hell, it's grippy. Fucking hell, it's quick as well, I'll tell you that. So I'm down 2 seconds on something. Don't know who these motherfuckers are who've put up lap times. Come on, Jamie boy. I'd like to watch a Pikes Peak race, actually. It just seems mental. It's kind of like an almost flat-out hill race. Nearly fucking lost it there. I'm down 4 seconds on something. AI, maybe. The AI is not very good on this. I'm playing this on medium. I think there is only one more level of hardness, which I should probably be putting it on. But I haven't yet. I should be putting it on the top level hardness, the pro. But then there's all the other options, such as taking off certain assists and making the handling more realistic. Fucking around with your suspension, your spoiler height, all of that good stuff is available in this game. It is fully customizable. Skateboard ramp. Let's try and catch this up. Just a teaspoon of brown sauce in your tea. How did you find out that you liked brown sauce in tea? What's fucking wrong with you, man? One day, did you have a cup of tea and go, oh, I fancy a bacon sarnie as well. I haven't got any bacon. I haven't got any bread. Fuck it, I'll throw the brown sauce in the tea. That'll do the job. I don't get you. I don't get it, man. It's a freaky fucking thing. Oh, right. Didn't need to brake around that corner. Freaky thing to do. Where do we come? First. There you go. I've set a time now on this. Happy times. Bosh. 1 minute and 59. I'm telling you, mate. No, I'm not wasting a cup of tea. I'm English. Tea is my jam. You don't fuck around with tea. Naughty. Naughty, Danny. You're a very naughty man. Jamie, do you know if you can download preset setups for cars for this game? I wouldn't know about the PC version. I really don't know. Certainly not for PlayStation 4. I mean, literally, all the setups are a nightmare. I leave everything on. I leave everything as it is, the presets. But I know for a fact, if I carry on playing this game as much as I played, for example, Sega Rally, I will find my perfect setup, as it were. Right, so let's back out of here. Brett, morning everyone. I sense people were talking about brown sauce and it led me here. Yes. What's better on a bacon sarnie? Brown sauce or just ketchup? Which one? Which one? Or both? Or maybe you're a mustard and ketchup or brown sauce man. I don't know. You guys let me know. There is only one right answer, by the way, and that is brown sauce on bacon. All right. Now, what I want to do here, I want to try and do a Pike's Peak actual race. Let's try and find one. Extreme. Richie, how are you? There's Pike's Peak. I've not done one of these before. Bosh. Tomato sauce, says Rich. Rich is a wrong'un. If I was having two bacon sarnies, I'd have one with brown, one with red. But if I was just to have the one sarnie, I'd definitely only have brown. Bacon, fried egg, and brown sauce, delicious. Yes, that is part of being British. Or Irish, I suppose. Although Irish, I'd probably have a sausage in there as well. Don't know why. Rich says he is all good. Boom! I've managed to up the power of my e-cigarette considerably by just changing one little element in here. And it's breathed a whole new life into it. And I've had this model for over a year and I've only just clocked that you can do this. Bacon and mushrooms. Mmm. You guys are making me hungry. If anyone, and I mean anyone, puts ketchup on a bacon sandwich, nay, any sandwich, unabashed slappings will be administered. That's the best fucking... Oh, mate, I'd have that on my work signature, but I'd probably get fired. Jay, you need to watch a film called Intermission. You'll understand a brown sauce, then love. Sounds good. Any film that features brown sauce in it, it's a winner. Unless brown sauce is a euphemism. Right, come on, JJ. You can do this. JJ's on this shit. So, I've got no pace notes in this. There's probably a reason for that. I couldn't tell you what it is. Does Pike's Peak ban co-drivers? I don't know. Are they called co-drivers? Are they called co-pilots? Are they called annoying wankers in the passenger seat? Are they called backseat drivers? I just don't know. I do love this game, though. I really, really love this game. We get sent a lot of promos, and we're kind of like, yeah, it's a good game, it's a good game. But it's very rare that we get sent promos that we actually love. And I tell you what, there is another one that Mark was sent from Bandai Namco, and that's Naruto Ultimate Ninja. And I've got to say, I love that. I didn't know what the fuck was going on in it, but the word love does spring to mind. That is awesome. So expect a video when the embargo drops. I think it was on the 4th. We will be releasing that video of me and Mark hammering the living shit out of each other with big rock monsters and fuck knows what else. Mad masks. Get back on circuit, you bell. That's it. Bit of acceleration. Wow, I've only just done the first sector and I'm 25 seconds up. You know why? Because I'm a fucking boss. I'm going to boot it. I'm going to try and finish over a minute ahead of the competition. Not going to do it like this. Fucking hairpins. I still can't do them. I'm shit at drifting in this as well. There is a drift mode. Or drift events, I should say. I was fucking dog shit at drifting. I don't think I can drift this car. It's got too much grip. That's it. Come on, boy. What you're witnessing here, you're about to see records getting smashed. Mm-hmm. Now, there is one racing game coming out that I'm very excited about, and that, well, there's two actually. MXGP 2, I can't wait for that. MXGP 1 was absolutely stunning by Milestone, same company who did this. But another racing game I am jolly excited about is Trackmania Turbo. Have you guys seen the hype behind that? That looks awesome. Looks like, I don't know, Hot Wheels on steroids. I've had that on my Steam wish list for a jolly long time. There we go. Right. I'm nailing this. Yeah, buddy. 1 minute. I'm a minute up. Who the fuck are the competition? They are shit. Whee, rewind. Come again, my selector. Man, I'm useless at racing games. It's kind of what I'd consider my genre. I bloody love racing games. Each game feels unique. You've got to get used to the handling, the tracks. You've got to know how the game plays. And that takes commitment. You can only be good at racing games with commitment. Unlike, you know, sort of platformers or whatnot, you don't need to be as committed. You can jump in, jump out. But in order to get properly good at something like this, you have to play it consistently over a long period of time, trying different modes, trying different tactics. Some people are like, oh, it's just a racing game. Just go round in a circle. But it's not like that at all. I've been playing racing games since way back in the day. My passion for racing games started officially at Sega Rally on the Saturn. That was around the same time I had a job at a go-kart track. And it just spiraled out of control, really. Now I'm like a crackhead for racing games. Ah, ball bag. Let's not waste a rewind. So remember, the last time I did this circuit, I think it's this one, I did it at, I think it was 15 minutes. I'm going to have a lot of your chat to catch up on, guys, at the end of this. But I will read every single message, I do promise. I've got my tablet next to me. I can scroll back along the messages. So just if you've got any questions or observations or general chit chat, crack on as if I was there or wasn't, depending on what you're talking about. I'm a minute and a half up. Oh, motherfucker, rewind. Motorcycle Club. Now there's a stinker. Yes, that got absolutely fucking panned, didn't it? I haven't played that yet. I don't think I want to. Apparently, the sound effects are one of the most horrific things on Earth. And that's reminded me of another Milestone game, which is Ride. This sort of arcade, released at around the same time as Motorcycle Club, but it's by Milestone. They just keep on getting better and better at games. I loved Ride. Haven't played that in a while. Motorbike racing is not my thing, really. But they did a jolly good job with that. Jolly good. Milestone really are the company to keep an eye on. There is one true master at racing games, and that is Codemasters. They are the masters of coding. But Milestone, you know, Codemasters have got to be a little bit restless at night. So, Codemasters have obviously got the big racing license in the they've got the F1 franchise sewn up, but Milestone are picking up these little niche markets, and they're doing nicely. I've never played a WRC game, actually, never, and I don't know why. Potentially I will pick one up ASAP. But guys in the chat, let me know what you think the best WRC game is, and is it worth me picking up? I don't want to pick up a game and then it be a stinker. That would just depress me. He's doing all right. He's doing all right at this. Yes, sir. Nearly 2 minutes up. And we still got another whole sector to go. Nailed that. Bollocks. What I'm going to do when this race is over, I'm going to stick the replay on so you can watch it in its glorious cinematic views, and I'm going to catch up on the chat. Where is Pikes Peak in the world, guys? Drop a comment if any of you know where the Pikes Peak race is held. I don't know. Is it somewhere in Europe? Is it in America? Clearly, I haven't done my homework. It's very nice terrain, though. I like this. This reminds me of when I went on a coach trip in Nevada to the Grand Canyon. Although, there's a lot more snow here. Right, should be coming up to the end within the next minute or so. Fucking hell, losing control. Come on, come on. What have we got? Hairpin. Hairpin right. Absolute dog shit. Come on, come on, come on. And over finish. Boom. Whoop. Is Pikes Peak not in Colorado? There you go, Colorado. So yeah, it reminded me of Nevada. Just the terrain here. Wow. Absolutely smacked it. So let's just watch a replay with L1. And let's catch up on your chat. Right. Right, the film is from 2003. That is the intermission film that Danny has suggested. Yes, Jamie, we Irish will chuck sausages and potatoes into anything. Sandwiches, fry up, cereal. Always feel sorry for co-drivers. Rarely remembered when it comes to championships, says Kev. Jamie, have you done a track day and tried some cars out? I haven't. I don't hold a driving license. I don't know how to drive a car. But I used to work at a go-kart track. 200cc, single engine, indoor carts. I've raced 400cc twin engine carts outdoor on slick tires, on wet weather tires as well. I've done my stint of racing. Yes, the cars are automatic. There's no gearing or anything. It's just right foot accelerator, left foot brake. Never touch both at the same time. You'll burn out the fucking clutch. But yeah, I worked there for several years. I've been racing go-karts since I was a little un. Thusly, I think racing is ingrained in me. Do I want to drive? Yes, I do want to drive. At some point, I will learn to drive, and then I'm sure I'll try an open day when I get confident enough. I don't need to drive because I live in the centre of London, and honestly, you don't want to drive in London. Is Naruto open world like the other ones? This Ultimate Ninja is a fighting game. I haven't tried out the adventure, just two-player fighting for a video for our channel. I can name Nicky Grist. That's about it. Talking about co-drivers, Kev. Don't even think he had a title. Man, I'm useless at racing games. Says it's the gay Klingon. Good name. I've just had my brunch, had toast, two bacon, two eggs, beans, mushrooms, and fried fresh tomatoes, no sauce. Man, I still haven't eaten since yesterday. I haven't eaten since yesterday lunchtime. I'm hungry. I love the MX games, says Rich. They are so good. I've had Trackmania on my wish list for months, but no release date yet. I thought it was coming up in about maybe quarter two this year. Not sure. What do you think about Project Cars? I love it. Graphically, it's beautiful. I've got it on the PC. I want to get it on a console so I can just sit down here and dedicate myself to it. I just find gaming on a console a bit more natural for me. So when it drops in price, I will get it for this. Absolutely loved it, mainly for the Côte d'Azur track, because that is the area where my mother used to live, and I know all the roads that are on that circuit. So it's just it's great nostalgia for me. Did you ever play a racing game called Nailed? Really fun racing game, really fun racer, says Bangkok. No, I didn't. Nailed. I've seen it. I've definitely seen it. I will add that to my wish list. Do you remember when Codemasters first started with budget games on the Spectrum and C64 BMX Simulator? Yes, I do. I've got a whole load of Codemasters old school games just over there, on tape, nonetheless, for Spectrum, Amstrad, everything. Best official WRC game is WRC 2001 on the PS2. Excellent. I will pick that up. I'm trying to up my PS2 games collection from, I think it's about 350 or so games at the moment. I want to up it, seeing as there's about 3,000 games. Catch you again, Jay, says Danny. Take it easy, Rude Boy. Going to go and play Life is Grim. Strange. is PP not in Colorado? Colorado. In terms of new ones, WRC 4 from Milestone. WRC 5 is a new developer and needs a year or two to really find their feet. Okay, okay. Yes, DDM. Don't know what that's in relation to. Great sense of speed in this game. Yes, there really is, isn't there? take it easy, Dan. Have you ever heard of Banger Racing? Yes, I've heard of Banger Racing. I drove a Lamborghini and a Ferrari at Silverstone. Silverstone is where, just literally a probably less than 10-minute drive from Silverstone, is where my mother-in-law lives, and that's where my wife is today. And about three weekends ago, we actually just drove down to the village of Silverstone and passed the circuit. Oh, so glorious there. I still remember Codemasters and Dizzy. What do you mean you remember Dizzy? What do you mean you remember Dizzy? You mean this motherfucker? This little eggy motherfucker? I love Dizzy. I am a Dizzy fanboy. They should do a new Dizzy game. There is talk. There is talk. I've got insider information. The developers of Dizzy. Right, the developers of Dizzy are a guy called the Oliver Twins, and the Oliver Twins are making this game here. I don't know if you can see it, Sky Saga, and they've actually they sent me a little note, and I can't find it, handwritten thing, just saying thanks for checking out Sky Saga or something. But I have insider information that maybe a new Dizzy is on the cards. There is a lot of love for Dizzy. Dizzy and Micro Machines. Micro Machines is the ultimate. Now, there is a new Micro Machines, and I think it's by Codemasters. It's not Micro Machines. They've lost the franchising rights to that. It is called Toy Box Turbos. That is by Codemasters. It's essentially a cuter version of Micro Machines. That is really fun. I've got that stuff. I've still got that stuff. Oh, yes, Brett, we need to sort that out. Got to go, man. Kev, not a problem, mate. Thank you very much for joining the stream. Right, that's enough talking. Wow, you guys, you went in on the chat while I was busy Pikes Peaking it. And sorry, while I was reaching for those Dizzy games, I did pull my microphone out. Right, let's back up. So apparently, this game has the realest circuits ever. They're not estimations of circuits. They have scanned the tracks. All right, I don't know what that means, but they have scanned, and they're like millimeter accurate, all the circuits in this game. Tell us all about Dizzy, Jamie, or it's Tommy sauce on your bacon sarnie. essentially, I have an industry friend, quite big in the games industry, and he knows how much of a Dizzy fan and Oliver Twins fan I am. And he was at a game show, and he had a one-on-one interview with the Oliver Twins, and he just said to me beforehand, "Tell me, Jamie, what do you want to ask the Oliver Twins? I'll ask them for you." And I said to him, "Just one fucking thing. Just tell me, are we getting a new Dizzy?" And they weren't there to talk about Dizzy. They were there to promote their Sky Saga. But let's just say his answer gave me hope. All right? His answer gave me hope. Right, let's crack on. I think I need to put this game to bed for a little bit. Just to... I've played it so much. I want to shoot stuff. I want to shoot some stuff. I want to bring a fucking shooter and shoot somebody. Ding, 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 ding. Come on. Am I in 220? Oh, look. I need to up one position and then I can play the next Sebastian Loeb event. Right, let's do another race and then I'll do the next Sebastian Loeb event and then I will clear off for a little bit and go and try and eat, because you lot talking about fucking bacon all the time, you bastards. So that was extreme. There's another hill climb. Oh, you've seen the hill climb. Let's not do any more hill climbs. Let's do... let's do... Try the new Warhammer 40k online shooter. Oh, I don't know about that. Not really down with the whole Warhammer Games Workshop, MMO. I'm not really... I've never been into it. Never been into it. Not into RTSs, strategy, things like that. Just don't tickle my funny bone. Got it earlier today and it's very good. What cars do you start with in this game? Oh, the car you start with in this game is cracking. This car they give you is where is she? There she is. A little Peugeot 106. Isn't she gorgeous? 165 horsepower, 1600cc, front wheel drive. Fucking brilliant. And from there, I went and bought this bad boy with my winnings. From there, I bought this. I then decided to dabble with this. Then this. I went on to win this and win this. These orange cars you win. And then I just started spunking my cash all over the place. As you can see, I've got 692,800 credits. I can buy any car in this game. The cars are priced very, very cheaply in this game. Chunky, take it easy. Does it have the option for you and your girlfriend's name on the windscreen? Yes, it does. Not on the windscreen, no. On the side of the car. If we back out... I can't really show you in this part. But you... hang on, I might be able to show you. Race options, maybe? No, not in here. But you can have your initials on your window, on the side window. I've got my initials and my co-driver is Mark in this, allegedly. So, yes. Right, come on, career. Another career mode. There's no fluffy dice in this either. Master, vintage. Let's go vintage. Let's go for a class 4. Let's go for a bit of Welsh. Class 4. The Lancia Stratos. 10,000 metres, so this is about a 5-6 minute race. Hafren 2, I hope I'm pronouncing that right. It's Welsh, so probably not. That's probably pronounced Peter 2. What a great game. Absolutely great game this is. Here we go. Right, let's assume the ready position. Stratos brings back memories of Sega Rally. Yes, they have the Lancia Delta in this as well, and a Toyota Celica is in this. So all three Sega Rally cars are in this. Racing games have come a long way. We've got 70 out of the box cars in this. They had what, three circuits in Sega Rally as well? There's 56 or something in this.
Right four very long.
One thing I do like about this, on time trial, there is a ghost mode in this. Oh, this car handles like a fucking banana on ice. And this circuit is especially deadly.
Right 5, 50.
Left 4, 80. So we're going to jam the brakes on for a 4. Left 5, long. 50. I've got this.
Right 6, minus.
So let's. There's the minus. Left 6. Left 4, Titans. So we've got to be handy on the brakes here.
Right 3, and left 5, minus. And right 6, 50.
Got to jam that right round. Didn't listen to the rest of this, but there's a right 6 coming up. Here it is. Fuck me, I'm definitely going to crash in this race. Called it.
Right 4, left 6, long. Right 3 opens and right 3 plus long.
Oh my god, the sectors are so long, I don't know if I'm doing shit or not yet.
Right 6 and left 5 very long.
I think this is a rear wheel drive because it's the handling is terrible.
Right 5 and left 5 plus.
Oh my god, I am so right far down on the sector open. Time.
Right 6 and crest bump and left 6 50.
Right, let's try and pull this back. 6 seconds down, I can do this. I can do this. I was going to give up, but I might as well go for the challenge. The brakes are pretty handy on this, and the it does correct itself pretty quick if you oversteer or understeer it. It corrects pretty nicely. Left 340. Bit of slide there, bit of drift.
Right 6 and left 5 tightens into hairpin left.
That's it. Put it on two wheels. It's fine. No one's going to remember. It's fine. They will remember that though. This and the Oculus would be interesting. I'd get motion sickness. I'd need a sick bag. I'd need to wind the fucking window down.
Right 3 and left 4.
This and the Oculus and the cockpit cam. Bloody hell. Could you imagine?
Left 6 into right 5, 50.
Left 6 into right 5, 50.
Left 5, 70.
Left 5, 70. Here we go. Bit of pace now.
Left 4, 100.
It's alright. Don't worry about that grass.
Left 6 plus.
Left 6 plus. Right 5, 50.
Right 5 and right 6
plus. Rewind coming up. There it is. Ah. Nice. Is the Samsung VR good? Ah, got the Samsung VR. Do you know what's really fucking annoying? The Samsung VR doesn't work on the Samsung Edge. I've got the Samsung Edge. It works for the S6, not for the S6 Edge. What the fuck is that about? So I buy their flagship phone, the most state-of-the-art technology screen and whatnot, and their most state-of-the-art technology peripheral doesn't fucking work on it. Rewind, fucking hell. Yeah, I'm not going to finish this race. I'm a tech geek. I've got a Samsung Galaxy Tab S2. I've got the Samsung... fucking hell, I can't concentrate and drive at the same time. The Samsung Galaxy S6 Edge. And yeah, I can't actually buy the VR thing. Outrageous.
Right 5 plus 80. Left 3, 50. Left 6, 90.
That edge right technology.
70.
Absolute pointless gimmick.
Right 6 and left 5.
Right, minus. This sector I need to be about 3 seconds down.
Right 6 and left 6. Left 4 and right 3. Left 6 and right 3 plus.
That's good, that's good. Right 3 plus. It's nice, fast.
Left 4, 230.
Okay. Sorry guys, I will again catch up on your chat after this race. Man's trying to concentrate right now, you know what I'm saying? 3 seconds, yep, that's fine with me. I'm catching up slowly. Somehow. Right 3, very long, 40. Fucking hell, that's tight as a nun's bits and pieces. Down we go. That's it. Open her up.
Into left 5 and right 4. And left
bump into
plus.
Left. Fuck.
Left 6 and left 3 plus. Very long and 60.
3 plus. We can accelerate a little bit round here.
Right 4 opens. And
remember guys, if you're not subscribed 80. And you you're feeling lovely, hit the subscribe button. And you will be notified upon our stream commencement. All right. You will also be notified when we drop a new video on YouTube. And we release new videos every single week. Loads of new videos. Whether it's retro games, which is the majority of our videos. Or whether it's brand new things, promos. We get a lot of games early. So depending on embargoes or not, whatnot, there we go, I'm up. Depending on embargoes, you might even get to see some exclusive game footage. I had this game, Sebastian Loeb, a week before it came out. Unfortunately, I wasn't allowed to show anyone it because of the embargo on it. And I love Milestone and P-Cube, the UK distributor of Milestone games. And I wasn't going to piss on their parade and go against their wishes. So I held it back until embargo release. And I'm still giving it loads of love because I love it. Here we go. This is a bit better. It's doing all right now. It's getting a hang of this little beastly Stratos. I say little, it's a fucking monster. This is it, coming up to the end now. Ah, grass. Let's rewind that. Whee! Put it sideways. Think I'm going to come right back to here. Just jam the brake on a little bit, try and get some more track time. There you go. Right, bump, left 6, finish. Open up the gas. Boom. Round he goes. Bosh. Did he get a gold? He got a gold. Right. So that should put me up into about 219th on the leaderboard. Let's have a look. 10 seconds up. Nicely done. Right. Let's scroll down. See what you guys are saying. Let's see where I am on the leaderboard first. Come on, come on. Hello, George. Right, here we go. 220, 19. 19 is enough. I can now do my next mission. Right. So, right, enough of your co-driver does sound like Mark. This and the Oculus would be interesting. Got the Samsung VR this week, says Bangkok. Very impressive. Nice. Is the Samsung VR good? Very good, mate. There's a great Zelda-style game for it. I hope they support them this time. Samsung, you bitch. Don't forget who supports your products. Must have 20 games for it already. Defo will check it out. Quake is amazing on it, too. Co-driver sounds like my DA. My DAR. What's that? What's that man to say, Brett? She meant to be Northern Irish, or is he just generic Pikey too? Jamie, are you going for the full PS2 collection? I'd love to. I would love to. At the moment, I'm just picking up. I'm going to do a pickups video this weekend. Let me show you in one second what I've grabbed this week. Did I stream yesterday? No, we didn't. No, we didn't stream yesterday. Right, here's some of my pickups this week on PS2. Oh, there's more than a handful here. I can't reach. You can just hear games going everywhere. I'm picking up very shitty games at the minute. I love shitty games. RTX. Don't know what that is. This isn't a shitty game. This is Warriors. I did a little play of that on our channel this week. My Street. The Mummy. That's right. Asterix at the Olympic Games. Why? Don't know. Kids Sports Ice Hockey. Giants Citizen Kabuto. Don't know. At the Races presents Gallop Racer. Fiddy in a House. Peter Pan. Something Neverland. Motor Siege Warriors of Primetime. There you go. That's my shitty games picked up this week. I'm waiting on a bundle of UGO games, but the motherfucker hasn't sent them yet, and I bought them last week. Last Sunday. Right, let's back out. Dar, how we backward Irish pronounce the word dad. Ah, I got ya. Right, we're going to do this Loeb event, and then I'm going to call an end to this stream. There we go. Rallycross race. Fuck. And your car is the Delta Integrale 8V. Very sexy. Ah, it's an event car, so I will unlock this if I win the race. Warriors is a great game by Rockstar. Yes. Oh, my God. I hadn't played that before last week or the week before last, and I made a video of it, and I fell in love with it instantly. Here we go. So this will take a minute 45 to load. Looks like there's a Joker lap in here, so we shall see. We took off the second day as our economy is in the shitter and we had to prioritize food over continents. So, Bangkok, are you a retro gamer? I am assuming you are. If you are, you are in the right place, mate. The Games Shed, we cover so much retro. So much retro. I am surrounded by the likes of the Mega CD, Mega Drive 2. I've got a SNES there, OG Xbox, a PS2. I've got a ZX Spectrum Plus 2. I've got a Nintendo Super Scope just there. I've got a wall full of Mega Drive games, SNES games, N64 games, NES games. There's a Neo Geo X up there, Nintendo GameCube, Barcode Battler, Atari 2600, NES. That's just over there. Some Saturn games. Over there. That's another story. Oh, excuse me. Devon, welcome. Devon. I have the Retro Freak console for retro. Ah, yes. I was looking at that. I'm not entirely sold on it yet. I've got all the original hardware here. As opposed to, I haven't got a Retron 5 or a Retro Freak or anything, but I'd love a Retro Freak. I don't know if they're available yet in the UK. I think PlayAsia are stocking them. My attic is full of retro everything, starting in the 70s. Gary, get it out of your fucking attic and send it to my house. Yes, very much want this. I very much want this competition car. Oh, Christ. Here we go. This is going to take me two or three attempts, guys, because the AI is a bastard in this, and they will shove you into walls just like this. I might be able to get them on the Joker lap, actually. Right, I should probably restart already, but I'll have a lap or two, see how I feel. Right, I'm doing my Joker lap early. Oh, let's rewind. Cut that corner way too tight. So the Joker lap is your one extra long lap that you must do in order to complete this stage. I can't see anything. Right, here we go. Now's my time. I'm a second down. That's fine. Wow, the handling on this fucking Delta is shit. So hopefully some of them should spin off to the left here and do their Joker lap, and I should be able to spin round and do the good stuff. Yeah, there we go. Someone spun off. Foot to the floor. And it did me absolutely no good. I'm definitely going to have to retry this race. Yeah, let's just restart. It just turned into Fast and Furious. Slow and lethargic. Restart. Retron 3 is really good. I'd not buy anything other than a Retron 5 just for HDMI purposes. I need an HDMI cable just for recording purposes. Three, on my PC.
Two, one, go.
Here we go. Right, let's be an asshole about this. Let's use other cars for our steering. Or not. Let's get up the inside. Come on, motherfuckers. They really are assholes, the AI. Oh, bitch. All right. Change of plan. Change of plan. It's worked out quite nicely. I fucking hate these races. Come on. I got this. I haven't got this at all. Not at all. It's that last corner is a bit of a bitch. So they're all going to do their Joker lap next. Come on. There's a wall there. Wow, I am shockingly bad. They're all going to take Joker right now. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. Foot down. Wasn't wide enough on that turn. And I'm still in fifth. And that is where it's going to end. Never mind. And that is game. Right. Drop a mushroom. Wish I could. What's up, son? Yes, AG. You have come right at the end of the stream, because I am going to go. Hour and a half in. I need to go and eat. Haven't eaten in 24 hours. Literally haven't eaten in 24 hours. I've got to go and eat. That is an hour and a half of Sebastian Loeb Rally Evo. And I have finished on a fail. Yet I managed to win every other race. Never mind. Never mind. These things happen sometimes. That was fucking poor, actually. Absolutely poor. Never mind. Well, guys, thank you very much for joining us. And if you want to see more of this, I will be streaming later. I will potentially be streaming this. I don't know yet. I might grab a new game that's out. I don't know what, though. But I will be streaming on this platform on what's this thing called? YouTube Gaming. Yes. So thank you very much, everybody. And I will see you later.